Hello guys, today I'm going to show how to open this Walkman WM-EX19 and pretty much all the Walkmans from this generation which are based on WM-EX10 FX10, which Sony was making from 1990 to I think 1999 for almost a decade. This one, when I push a button, it makes whirring sound, so the motor is intact, I presume electronics is intact, and the only issue is probably the rubber belt, which either broke or turned to goo. So I'm going to open it up. I'm going to try two different belts, a thicker and a thinner, and I'm going to run some tests for wow and flutter and decide whether thinner belt is better than thicker and how much it is better. So stick around, it should be informative. Different Sony manuals depending on a model recommend opening those latches, which Sony calls claws, in different order. So some manuals say open these inside first and then open the ones on the perimeter. Other manuals say open first the middle and the left, and then open some of the on the back, and then open the right one. I don't think there is a big problem if you open them in slightly different order. From my experience, this, the leftmost, is the most prone to breaking, so be careful with that. Also, Sony recommends using flat screwdriver to opening these claws. I'm going to use this wooden stick from a Chinese restaurant because it has bigger area here. Because I don't want to damage those claws any more than they already seems to have been damaged. So I'm just pushing in this one, and this one, and then I'm going to take a screwdriver. And Sony recommends order. Which order does it recommend? Okay, I'm orienting this way and going A, B, this side, all the way to this side. Okay, so I'm trying to open it without breaking. The damn thing keeps latching up again. It doesn't want to be opened. Okay, I have some minor progress. Stay there. Then we push this guy again. This guy. Okay, now it opened up. Yes, finally, we're getting somewhere. And down here. D, then E, I think, between the buttons. These two are always all okay. I got it. Now, you can see, so here's the top where the cassette compartment is, the buttons, and then this is the back cover. I remove the back cover, and here is the mechanism. It's right there. It was making noises when I put the battery, but nothing was moving. So let's figure out, is it because of the belt or something else? Okay, see, the belt kind of is snapped, either because it's it's all stretched out and it lost all its elasticity. Actually, yeah, I mean, the good thing is that it didn't turn into goo. It simply lost its elasticity. Now I removed it. Now I can clean up all this mechanism and put in a new belt. And now you can see how the whole thing is built. If you look at this side, where the cassette goes in, this is a magnetic head. This is a capstan. This is a pinch roller. And on the on models with auto reverse, there is another capstan on the left and another pinch roller. And you can see that on this model, the capstan simply has been shortened. It's still rotating. It's as if it's like a real capstan. It still rotates, but there is no additional pinch roller. And on the back, that's a flywheel for the main capstan, and this is a flywheel for the capstan for auto reverse, and that's electric motor over here, and that's the whole mechanism, which is all plastic, and it's mounted on the circuit board, which is also works like a frame. Now, after I cleaned up this gear, I'm going to put some of this synthetic lubricant. This one is Mollycoat, which is one of the lubricants, as far as I know, compatible with plastic. Not all lubricants are compatible with plastic. You cannot put regular grease that you use for cars, for example, because all these plastic parts will basically turn to goo. So now I'm going to put a belt, and I have two different belts. I have a kind of common one. First of all, that's a belt from another Walkman of the same family. You can see it's rather thin. And this is belts that I got from a company. I'm not going to name it. They say that it's compatible, and yes, I can put it on, but it's notably thicker. So the original ones, I think it's 0.6 or something millimeter, and this is 0.9 millimeters. So they're thicker. I can put them on, but if you put a thicker belt, then your wow and flutter parameters usually go way out of spec. But it depends. We're going to check it right now. And then like this, and you need to make sure that the belt is not twisted. Because if it twisted, then again your wow and flutter will go out of spec. So it looks fine. So let's check it. I have an app to check for wow and flutter, and I have a tape. It's not a professionally made tape, but still it's good enough. It's better than nothing. So we see about 0.25 with peaks hitting about 0.45. So I'd say that if it continues to play like this without, you know, slowing down, then that's pretty reasonable numbers for a player like this. But now I'm going to try a thinner belt and see whether it will bring any noticeable improvement. So these belts are noticeably thinner, right? So that's the belt that I bought from the US distributor, and that's the guy, it's from Czech Republic. It's noticeably thinner, and the original Sony's belt is over here. So this guy's belt is even thinner than Sony's, which kind of makes me wonder, maybe it's too thin. Okay, so I'm going to put this one. It will be a challenge because, you know, getting it correctly in the groove, I don't have an eyesight as good as I used to have. So I replaced the rubber belt. I put some grease on these black gears. And the final thing that you can do after you open it, actually you can do it even without opening your Walkman. You can adjust the speed. You see this hole? It goes right in here. There is a small screw in there. And this app, it shows the frequency, which should be about 3 kilohertz, give or take 45 hertz, so 1.5%, and wow and flutter, here are the numbers. And I'm going to test it again. I already adjusted the speed, turn it on, and then start. And you can see my tape speed is about 3000. It shouldn't be more than 345 and shouldn't be less than 55. So it's within spec. And my wow and flutter, they're okay. You can see it's about 0.2 for a Walkman of this type. That's reasonable numbers. So I just listened to a tape with a lot of piano and strings, and it sounds okay to me. So I'm going to call this done, and I'm going to close that cover, and that's it. I'm done with this Walkman. Let's stop it. So to close it, you just carefully put it on top of this. I think I'd rather should open this guy and just click it into place, like just like this. I'm afraid not to break anything that I haven't broke yet. Okay, maybe start from here, or maybe from here. Come on. Okay, let's click into place. And I need to verify from the inside. I'm going to take my measuring tape away, that my claws have clicked into place. I can even press from the bottom and make sure that they all are here. So this, the leftmost one, it didn't seem to click into place because I damaged it, but that's okay, it will still hold up. As long as, yeah, I can put battery in and another battery in here. And that's it. I'm done. WM-EX19 with Dolby. Pretty nice, cheap Walkman. That's it. Thank you. Goodbye.